Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my third lecture on autocorrelation function. Here we are going to see what is power spectral density function, cross spectral density function, the properties of power spectral density functions and few examples to illustrate power spectral density functions. Now, what is power spectral density function? If x of t is a stationary process either in the wide sense or in the strict sense, that is x of t is a stationary process, either a WSS process or a SSS process with the autocorrelation function Rxx of tau, then the Fourier transform of Rxx of tau is known as the power spectral density function of the random process x of t. Already you have studied Fourier transform in your third semester, so I need not recall that. I am just using the transform definition. So Sxx of omega equal to integral minus infinity to infinity Rxx of tau e power I omega tau d tau. And the inverse Fourier transform of S of omega, that is power spectral density function, is the autocorrelation function. Now similarly, for defining cross spectral density function, you consider two random processes x of t and y of t which are jointly WSS with the cross correlation function Rxy of tau. Then the Fourier transform of Rxy of tau is known as cross spectral density function. Now we see some of the properties of power spectral density functions. First one, property 1, the value of the spectral density function at zero frequency is equal to the total area under the autocorrelation function. This is easy to explain because you just have to consider the definition of power spectral density function. There you put omega equal to 0. So this right hand side you get e power 0 which is 1. So it is simply integral minus infinity to infinity Rxx of tau d tau. So S of 0 equal to integral minus infinity to infinity R of tau d tau. By the basic knowledge and mathematics, you know that this represents the total area under the graph of R of tau. So this represents the total area under the autocorrelation function. Now we consider the second property. The mean square value is equal to the total area under the spectral density function. What is mean square value? Already we have seen in the previous two lecture. It is nothing but expectation of x square t. In terms of autocorrelation function, it is R of 0. Now you just consider the inverse Fourier transform of this spectral density function, which is R of 0. There you put tau equal to 0. So you get R, that is, you consider this definition of inverse Fourier transform of R of tau in terms of the spectral density function. There you put tau equal to 0. Once again on the right hand side, this will become e power 0 which is 1. Therefore, you get R of 0 equal to 1 by 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity S of omega d omega. Now you take omega equal to 2 pi f, where f is the frequency variable, and then you do the differentiation on both sides, substitute in this integral. So you get R of 0 equal to integral minus infinity infinity S of f df, which represents the total area under the graph of S of f. Then we go to the third property, property 3, which says that the spectral density of a real random process is an even function. So already we have shown that in the previous lecture, that in the previous presentation, that the autocorrelation function is an even function of tau. Now I am going to show that the spectral density S of omega is an even function. That means what I am supposed to prove? I have to prove that S of omega equal to S of minus omega. So you simply consider the definition of spectral density function and then you replace omega with minus omega on both sides. And then you make the substitution tau equal to minus u. So you get R of minus u e power I omega u minus du. Okay. And then when you make the substitution, you get the lower limit is infinity and the upper limit is minus infinity. Tau becomes minus u, minus tau becomes u and d tau become minus du. And the when I interchange the limits, upper limit and lower limit, I'll get a negative sign. That negative sign along with this negative sign will become positive. So, and because our autocorrelation function is an even function, R of minus U is same as R of U. Therefore, this is the spectral density function. So, we have proved that S of minus omega is same as S of omega. Therefore, for a real random process, the spectral density is an even function of omega. Now, we go to the fourth property. What does the fourth property say? The spectral density of a random process X of T, the random process may be either real or a complex random process, it is a real function of omega. How do you show that a function is a real number? A function is a real function. If z equal to z bar, if z is a complex number, if z equal to its conjugate z bar, then we say that the number is a real number. Similarly, we say that a function is real if the function is equal to its conjugate. That's it. It's a very simple idea. Already, how do you define an autocorrelation function for a complex random process? It is expectation of x of t, x star of t plus tau. Then you replace tau with minus tau on both sides. Then you take conjugate on both sides. So if you take conjugate on both sides, x will become x star and x star will become x. Okay. And r star of minus tau is same as r of tau. Now you consider the definition of spectral density function. There you replace s with s star. Okay. You take conjugate on both sides. So s will become s star. R will become R star of tau, its conjugate, and the conjugate of e power I omega tau is e power minus I omega tau. Once again, as in the previous property, you substitute minus tau equal to u. So what are the changes that takes place here? Minus tau will become u, e power minus I omega tau, that will become plus u, and here the along with the change in the limits, the negative sign will go off, and this is the definition of the spectral density function, S of omega. So, S star of omega is equal to S of omega. Therefore, because the conjugate and the function, they are equal, the spectral density function is a real function of omega. Then, property 5. What does the property say? Property 5 say, the spectral density function and autocorrelation function of a real random process form Fourier cosine transform pair. So, this is also easy to prove. You consider the definition of spectral density function and you write e power I omega tau as cos omega tau plus I sin omega tau. That's a Euler's form. And you split this into two integrals. And because r of tau is even, cos omega tau is even, product of r of tau and cos omega tau is an even function. Therefore, integral from minus a to a of an even function will become twice 0 to a. That is twice 0 to infinity. Whereas, since r of tau is even, sin omega tau is odd, r of tau multiplied with sin omega tau is an odd function. Odd function integrated from minus a to a is 0. So, that's why that term did not come here. And this is nothing but Fourier cosine transform of 2r of tau. It's not Fourier transform, it's a Fourier cosine transform. By definition of Fourier cosine transform. Then you consider r of tau, the definition of r of tau, okay, that is 1 by 2 pi integral minus infinity infinity s of omega e power minus I omega tau d tau. That's the definition of Fourier and inverse Fourier transform of r of tau, okay. Then you substitute for e power minus I omega tau, that is cos omega tau minus I sin omega tau. Now for a real random process, we saw in property 3 that s of omega is an even function. Again, by the same idea, S of omega is even, sin omega tau is odd. So, odd function multiplied with even function is odd function. Odd function integrated from minus a to a is 0. So, that component will not come. So, you simply get twice 0 to infinity S of omega cos omega tau d tau. That 2 will get cancelled with this 2 in the denominator. That's why you have this 1 by pi alone. And this is nothing but Fourier cosine transform of half of S omega. So, S of omega and R of tau, because 2 and 1 by 2, this 2 and 1 by 2 are only constant terms. We say that S of omega and R of tau are Fourier cosine transform pairs. Now, we see some properties to illustrate autocorrelation functions and spectral density function. Now, you are given an autocorrelation function of a random telegraph signal process, R of tau equal to A square e power minus 2 gamma modulus of tau. You just have to find the power density spectrum of the random telegraph signal. Now we simply use the definition of S of omega, which is integral minus infinity to infinity r of tau. This is given to be r of tau e power I omega tau d tau. Then here you have this modulus. Modulus is an even function. E power I omega tau, you can write it as cos omega tau plus I sin omega tau. That sin omega tau becomes an odd function, so that you can eliminate. And e power minus 2 gamma modulus of tau and this cos omega tau, it becomes an even function. Even function from minus infinity to plus infinity, you can write it as twice 0 to infinity. And then you just integrate it using e power a cos bx formula and then substitute the limit. Okay, when you substitute the upper limit, e power minus infinity is 0, so the entire term goes off. When you substitute the lower limit, tau equal to 0, e power 0 is 1, cos 0 is 1, and sin 0 is 0. Just use all those values, you get the simplification is 4 gamma a square by 4 gamma square plus omega square. That is the spectral density for this given random telegraph signal process. Then we go to the second example. Here also you are given autocorrelation function of a WSS process, and you have to find the spectral density, corresponding spectral density. Once again, you just use the definition. Here r of tau is e power minus alpha tau square. Okay, then the base is same, naturally you have to add the power. So you'll get minus alpha tau square plus I omega tau. I want to express this as a perfect square in the form of a plus b whole square, something like this. So I consider the first term as, I take out minus alpha, I take tau square as the a square term, then minus I omega tau by alpha as 2ab term. So b square term is I omega by 2 alpha square. So I add b square. To balance it, I subtract b square. Okay, to balance it, I subtract b square. Then I take out the constant term. So this minus alpha multiplied with this minus will become plus. I square is minus, you know that. So that minus omega square by 4 alpha square has come out. 4 alpha square and along with this alpha, 1 alpha will get cancelled. So 4 alpha will come out. And the remaining 3 terms, tau square minus I omega by tau by alpha plus I omega by 2 alpha. These 3 terms will give you a minus b whole square. Okay, something in the form of tau minus I omega by 2 alpha square. Now you may take this term as your x. Differentiate on both sides, you will get dx equal to root alpha into d tau. Make all the substitutions, you get e power minus x square dx, and the value of e power minus x square dx using gamma function is root of pi. Actually gamma half is root pi. So the spectral density function is root of pi by alpha e power minus omega square by 4 alpha. Then we go to the third example. So here you are given the spectral density function S of omega. You have to find out the autocorrelation function. So this is the definition of autocorrelation function in terms of the spectral density function using inverse Fourier transform. And then you substitute for S of omega. Substitute for S of omega. That is b by a minus mod omega over the interval minus a to plus a. B by a, it's a constant, you can just take it out. And you write e power minus I omega tau as cos omega tau minus I sin omega tau. A minus mod omega is an even function. Sin omega tau is an odd function. Product of even and odd function is odd. So its integral value from minus a to a will be 0. So just remove the term. So you have to write only the remaining terms, a minus mod omega cos omega tau, because product of two even function is even. And the integral of an even function from minus a to a is twice 0 to a. When the limit is 0 to a, the value of mod omega is simply omega. And then you just have to integrate this using integration by parts. And then you substitute the limits, you get this value. And this is something like 1 minus cos theta, and 1 minus cos theta equal to twice sin square theta. 2 times sin square theta, where theta is omega tau. Okay, 1 minus tau divided by 2. So given the spectral density function, this is how you have to find out the autocorrelation function. Thank you.